on air, online, on your side. This is a KGUN9 News Update.
Hello, I'm Lydia Camarillo. With Arizona's concerns over growing COVID numbers, teachers were literally driving for change. The messages painted on car windows said it all. Teachers asking to keep schools closed until it's safe. More than 100 cars honked away. Participants saying it was too soon to go back to campus next month. And while most teachers say in-person teaching is more effective, they would rather keep instruction solely online until safety can be guaranteed. Well, it's three strikes and you're out for businesses in Pima County. This comes after county leaders revised rules for operating during the pandemic. Three violations can get a business's permit pulled now. They will still need to do wellness checks on employees and vendors, post signage urging customers with symptoms not to enter, provide sanitizing products and mask requirements. Tucson Council Member Steve Kosacek says he wants more from the governor's office. In a letter, Kosacek requested the governor give more power to cities and counties to enact their own COVID-19 rules. He called Ducey a, quote, bad actor, referring to a photo of the governor at a party after Memorial Day. In the picture, the governor is not wearing a mask then. Well, we're expecting to learn more about the Downtown Links Improvement Project today. Tucson DOT is holding a virtual meeting that starts at 5:30 this evening. In this meeting, they will be given an update on construction, timeline, and projects, improvements for the project, now which extends from Church Avenue to Broadway. Let's take a look at the forecast. It's shaping up to be another active day. Tucson will continue to see a chance for afternoon and evening storms through early next week. Flooding and blowing dust will be a concern with any developing storms. Highs will drop a few degrees into the weekend, then possibly as low as the 90s by the middle of next week.